now available in paperback. From the author of the critically acclaimed book, The Man Crisis, comes The Woman Crisis. Learn why so many women have become lost in their quest to have it all in The Woman Crisis. Get your copy of The Woman Crisis in paperback at Amazon.com and online booksellers today. One of my viewers wanted me to do another installment in the Historical Women in Crisis series. And for this installment in the Historical Women in Crisis series, I'm going to be talking about Diane Borchardt. Now, in 1979, your 31-year-old Diane Pfister met 25-year-old Reuben Borchardt, who was the father of two children from a previous marriage where his wife wound up passing away. And after your Reuben Borchardt married Diane Borchardt and looked to go out here and build a home with him with the brand new daughter he had with your Diane Borchardt, she started to show the Jekyll and Hyde personality that I talked about in my classic blog, Why Real Men Avoid Single Mothers. Now, your Diane Borchardt at the high school she worked at was a well-liked woman because she was always willing to help. And even the students at the school liked her a lot and called her Mrs. B. And this was just the Dr. Jekyll side of your Diane Borchardt, who was harboring a lot of insecurities as related to her personal life. And at home, that's where the Mrs. Hyde came out. Now, I believe your Diane Borchardt's Dr. Jekyll and Ms. Hyde personality came about because as an older woman, she was extremely insecure about being able to go out here and maintain a marriage and maintain the family that she had. And the fact that she had to go out here and come behind another woman, this exacerbated her insecurities and led to her becoming extremely frustrated because she had to come behind another woman who had passed away, and she was upset about this whole being the second choice as related to Reuben Borchardt, and she was also upset about having very little power as related to being able to choose a partner. And I believe that was the foundation of her frustration and her anger, having to come in to what we call in the black community a ready-made family. And as she came into this ready-made family, she was feeling powerless and feeling upset about the fact that she would have to submit not only to another man, but she would have to come behind another man's children. Because just like a lot of men don't like coming behind another man's children, a lot of women also don't like coming behind another man's children. And this is basically led to the issues as related to your Diane Borchardt's anger. And that anger was expressed in the disrespect she started to really show your Reuben Borchardt, because she did not respect your Reuben Borchardt as a head of household. And your Reuben Borchardt basically was looking like a simp in some ways, because instead of establishing himself as a male authority figure, he looked to submit to the older Diane Borchardt and looked to allow her to get power in the relationship. And this is where Tariq Nasheed talks about the seven levels of disrespect started to begin in the new home that he was trying to blend a family with. But as he tried to blend that family, all he got was disrespect and dysfunction. Now, as your Reuben Borchardt looked to lay the foundation for this new home, your Diane Borchardt, an older woman, looked to gain power and looked to demand that all the memories of your Reuben Borchardt's late wife be erased from the home. So she got rid of all of the pictures of your Reuben Borchardt's wife Susan, and wouldn't allow the kids to discuss her, even though they were grieving the loss of their mother, because both of these children were very little. So they wanted to remember their mother, but your Diane Borchardt, insecure about her place in the home, demanded that they would not discuss the late mother, and told the kids that she's no longer part of their lives because she was dead. This is a really cold way to treat children who are grieving their mother, and your Diane wanted to be able to take control over the home, and she wanted them to see her as the only mother. And again, this jealousy and insecurity over a dead woman, this is what led to her going out here and resenting your Reuben Borchardt's biological children and did not want to raise them as children at all. She was just really cruel to them and abusive, and she put all of her focus on her own child. But this is par for the course when you have a woman coming into another woman's home, because by nature, women look to nest in a home, and they look to go out here and make it their own home. And when there's another woman who was already in that home, they want to erase all parts of that woman from their home. Now, as your Reuben Borchardt was in this home with their Diane Borchardt, her insecurities made that home more and more dysfunctional. And as she looked to get more control over your Reuben Borchardt, who she was losing respect for basically every day, because your Reuben Borchardt did not go out here and set a boundary for how she would behave in his Jefferson, Wisconsin home. No, because he did not go out here and set a boundary for his home or take his respect, your Diane Borchardt continued to escalate her disrespect, which started when she took the pictures of his late wife out of his home and abused his children. She then went from abusing the children by erasing their mother's memory to going out here and looking to escalate her disrespect by going out here and perpetrating physical violence on your Reuben Borchardt. And your Reuben Borchardt, a beta male, refused to check Diane's behavior, and your Diane went from going out here and, again, I believe, making verbal attacks on this man, because usually women, they'll disrespect you verbally before they start disrespecting you physically. And in one argument, she is alleged to have smashed a flower vase on Reuben's head, and this further escalated into her calling the police and making false domestic violence claims, saying that Reuben assaulted her. And your Diane would start these fights where she would assault Reuben and then try to turn it around and make it look like the police like he hit her. And again, this is the behavior that your women participate in when they don't respect you. And because they don't respect you, what they do is escalate their behavior to become more violent. And that violence is because this man refuses to check that woman and let her know where the line is. And because your Reuben Borchardt didn't let her know where the line is, your Diane Borchardt kept pushing. And since she couldn't get him arrested, she went out here and escalated her behavior and went on further. Now, in 1993, your Reuben was pushed to the brink, but instead of him standing up for himself, what he did was try to walk away from your Diane Borchardt, and he went out here and found another woman, and that further made your Diane Borchardt enraged, because your women who are insecure like this, when they already have to deal with the fact that there was another woman in your life and they see a new woman in your life, that's when they go from simmering and boiling in anger to getting ready to explode in rage. And I talk about how this is what happens in the man crisis as related to beta males, but it also happens with your toxic females. And I talk about that in the chapter Murder and the Woman Crisis, because at this point, your Diane was extremely jaded when she heard that your Reuben Borchardt was getting ready to walk away from her. And as he was getting ready to walk away from her, what he was going to do was file for divorce. Because when she heard about that divorce, that's when your Diane Borchardt basically went nuclear at that point, because she saw that this man was going to go out here and take the power of, as related to his role as head and leader, over his home. And as he was getting ready to take that authority that he originally had, this is what led to your Diane Borchardt looking to go out here and get revenge against your Reuben Borchardt. As he filed for divorce, Your Diane Borchardt then wanted to go out here and file for the custody of his own biological children, making a false claim of constant neglect. However, Reuben got custody of his own children and his own home, and as he was establishing order in his home, the court ruled that Diane had to leave his home by April 15th, 1994. Now, the big problem with Reuben was, as he was standing up for himself, he was still afraid of his wife, and it's that fear that really didn't make him take further constructive action, because what he needed to do, instead of being afraid of your Diane who threatened to castrate him, was to pack up all of his stuff and his children and move out of that Wisconsin area, leaving your Diane basically ass out at that point. Unfortunately, your Reuben did not follow through with moving out, which is what I believe he should have done. Instead, he lined his stairs with mayonnaise jars as an alarm system in case Diane came into the home, but he should have been taking further action, like putting new locks on his doors and going out here and making plans to sell his home and move on. But what happened was, he thought he could stay in that area, and people knew that she had, your Diane was a manipulator, and she went to these three kids and told them that your Reuben Borchardt had been beating her, and recruited all three of them to go out here and murder your Reuben Borchardt, promising them cash, cars, and jewelry. And as she sent those three boys to her home, they all went out here and shot your Reuben Borchardt, and his son found him dying. And as the son found him dying, that's when the police came in eventually and wound up investigating the case, and found out that Diane Borchardt was the one who orchestrated this murder. And she orchestrated this murder because basically your Diane Borchardt was one of these females who was extremely insecure about being a part of another man's family. And this whole story of your Diane Borchardt really shows us why a man who already has been a widower and has children should not get involved with women, because a lot of these women, they get jealous of other women, and because they get jealous of other women, they just basically lose control of themselves. Now, I believe your Diane Borchardt, she lost control of herself because she was at a very deep inferiority complex and felt she couldn't compete with the memory of a dead woman. And that just shows how deep her insecurities were. And your Diane Borchardt was a classic female predator who really looked for these beta male simps like your Reuben Borchardt, looking for a man she could control. And that control is because she felt inadequate about herself. And because she felt inadequate about herself, she wanted to go out here and find a weak man she could control. And because she couldn't control this man, and this man started to stand up to her, she wanted to put him down. And that's why she went out here and recruited these three boys to go out here and murder her husband. And those three boys wound up murdering her husband. And as a result, all three of those boys wound up in prison for life sentences, as they were and now are being turned out by Bubba and Tiny as we speak, for your Little Debbie snack cakes, hot and sour ramen noodles, Kit Kat candy bars, your Crystal Light iced tea, Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle pies, hot sauce packets, cups of coffee, six-pack Oreo cookies, and Fritos chips. That's what those guys, all three of those boys, are being turned out for as we speak, as your Bubba, Tiny, Roscoe, and Big Mike are spit roasting them. That is the final fate that all of them got for the crime that they committed. And your Diane Borchardt was convicted of first degree murder and is now spending 40 years to life in prison. And she'll have to serve 40 years before she's eligible for parole. So your Diane Borchardt possibly will die in prison, and she'll die with the memory of having to go out here and get this revenge, and learn that this revenge only led to her losing her freedom. And now she's sitting in a prison with your Big Betty and Bertha, playing spades every day, all because she went and out here and got angry at a man for wanting to maintain the memory of his wife. But if she knew that this man was already a widower and had a family, she should have just walked away from that man instead of heading down the road to becoming a woman in crisis. Now, if you want to learn more about what leads to women like Diane Borchardt participating in the dysfunctional and violent behavior they participate in, you can pick up my book, The Woman Crisis, on Amazon.com in paperback and Kindle format. You can also find The Woman Crisis at other online booksellers like Smashwords, the iBookstore, Google Play, Barnes & Noble, and Walmart. And if you want to see me do more videos in the Historical Women in Crisis series, you can send me a Cash App or donate to the Patreon or PayPal. That's all I have to say for this video. You can comment, rate, and subscribe.
Now available in paperback and Kindle, Stop Simping in Cyberspace. Learn how to avoid predatory females like Instagram models and e-girls and their virtual con games with Stop Simping in Cyberspace. Get your copy of Stop Simping in Cyberspace in paperback and Kindle today.